been called the greatest free show on earth, a Catholic celebration with pagan roots, a farewell to the flesh, a last hurrah before the abstinence of Lent. For over 200 years, Mardi Gras in New Orleans has attracted visitors from around the world. But there is another Mardi Gras, which has remained elusive even to some natives of the city. This is the story of New Orleans Black Carnival. While you're going in New Orleans, you ought to go see the Mardi Gras. If you go to New Orleans, you ought to go see the Mardi Gras. When you see the Mardi Gras, somebody'll tell you what's carnival for. When New Orleans was founded by the French in 1718, they survived an extremely harsh environment with the help of a diverse Indian population which surrounded the city.
Louisiana has always been considered Choctaw country, but you had Natchez here, you had Muscogee Creek. This was a ceremonial area. It was called the City of the Ancient Ones. And they said that at one time, even way before their cultures, there had been another culture here, and they'd had a temple city here, they'd had a holy city here.
Despite the hardships of the new territory, the settlers clung to their European customs. Catholicism was the official religion, and carnival was celebrated in the Parisian style, with masked balls for the well-to-do and carousing in the streets. New Orleans developed into a multicultural, multi-ethnic city, incorporating French, Spanish, and African traditions.
During the period of slavery, the French were different from the British and these other colonizers. The French believed in keeping the family together. Even though slavery was horrible, there were a lot more compassion. And also they had Catholicism. They believed in drinking. You had wine at the mass. They believed in having fun.